Let's see how to paint dreadlocks. At this stage of the painting, the dreadlocks are just simple cylindrical volumes, just like a rope. Right now, I'm going to add some extra light to the dreadlocks in order to increase the sensation of volume. I'm using a color similar to the background light and short brush strokes to emulate the natural reflection of the hair. Now it's time to add some texture. What I have here is a texture created from a photo of a scourer. I simply play with the levels to add some more contrast and clones of parts of it to make it bigger. This will give me a base texture to work with. I'm going to copy and paste this photo over the image several times, turning it and erasing parts of it to blend it together. I will set the layer to soft light mode, and then I'm going to create a layer mask to apply the texture just where I want. Now I copy merge the whole image, and using the Born and Dutch tools, I add some extra lights and shadows to the dreadlocks. And now I'm going to paint some tangled hair. I'm going to use sharp brush strokes and a very small brush. I don't want all the hair to have the same luminosity, so I'm going to use Burn and Dodge again to make some parts darker and some others brighter. That's it. The process takes some time, but it's pretty easy and can give you some neat results.